Today, Allegra's gonna show you guys just a few different squat variations, a few different things that you could do to grow them quads, them hamstrings, the glutes. All the ladies out there, and maybe some dudes want glutes, I guess, I don't know. Weird. Whatever. Whatever you're into, you know. Do y'all want guys to have glutes? Y'all like, is that a thing?
No. I'd rather them have like proportional legs, but the glutes don't matter as much.
So they have a flat butt?
Okay, not flat, but.
A little something to hold on.
But it can't be bigger than mine.
Do you slap it? Would you slap a dude's butt?
That's not the direction I go.
All right, that's what's up. Anyway, you slap a girl's butt? Okay, all right. She didn't say no. But anyway, all right, so first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna squat with the safety squat bar. I'm a big fan of this bar. I have one in my garage, I use it all the time. There's different types of bars, different specialty bars that you can get. This is one of them. Another one is a Cambridge bar, which I'm a big fan of as well. And what they do is they put the weight in a different place. It just adds a variable to your squat to make you better at squats and back squats. It's harder to do. You're gonna feel it all in your core for real, because it's like pushing the weight forward. It's like a front squat. It helps keep you in a perfect position when you squat as far as form. And the bar is a lot heavier. It's at least, each bar is a little bit different. This one is at least 25 pounds heavier, so you know you have additional weight. All right, so she's gonna go ahead and start with a warm up with just the bar, and then we're gonna add a little bit of weight. Show you guys how it's done. Just 5 reps. Oh, good. Remember, explode up. 3. Oh. 5. Good. Okay, let's do 10 reps with this one. If y'all do get to use one of these bars, like I said, you're gonna feel it a lot in your core. Just try to keep your core really tight and explode up just like any other squat. Good. Knees out, good. Push up, good. Nice. Easy money. Let's go to a plate. All right, let's get it. We're gonna stay at 10 reps on this one. You got it. Oh, good. 2. 3, nice. 4. Now, some people might be wondering where you put your hands. Doesn't matter, wherever's comfortable. Come on, you can't get it wrong with this. Come on. Come on, drive. Nice. Good job. All right, let's get it. All right, 3 reps. That's good. Nice and tight. Oop. Nice. You see how, look, you see how she's getting that struggle reps? This is what you want. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. No help. Excellent, good. Let me tell you something, this is what you want. This is where the gains come from. This is when your body is forcing itself to adapt. When the work is easy, you're doing a little maintenance, but the real work is sets like this. The more you can be struggling in your workouts and during your progression, the better it is. Everything she did was to lead up to this point right here. Right? That was hard, right? Yeah. That's when your body starts to adapt. You're really tearing down those muscle fibers. Your body, your central nervous system is getting a fight or flight response. It's trying to figure it out. So it's gonna make sure when your body is repairing after you eat and drink some Planta, it's gonna repair in a way that it can handle this kind of threat the next time you have to do it. So that's what the body does. The body's magnificent. It just perceives as a threat, and it's gonna be like, all right, that shit sucked. Let me figure out how we don't struggle with that again so we can stay alive. It's all evolution, it's fucking crazy. Good set.
Boxing is physical intelligence at its finest.
Come on.
This is physical poetry.
Come on. Come on.
So scientific.
Come on. Come on.
Work your ass off.
Come on.
Then refuel with Planta.
Come on.
Available at the Ambrosia Collective.
Come on. Come on.
All right, so next we're gonna do pause reps. Pause reps will help increase power and explosiveness on a squat. Everybody's weakest point is below parallel. That's why you see people, when people doing half squats, they can load up a bunch of weight and do this shit right here. Everybody can fucking, you're strong right there, right? But that's where we at all day. We're walking, you're running. But to get beneath that, here's parallel, and then get all the way down there, that's people's weakest spot. But what powers that the most is your ass, your glutes, and your hamstrings. So this helps strengthen that. And also it just gets you comfortable in that uncomfortable position. People don't go all the way down because it's uncomfortable down there. So you start implementing pause reps in your regimen, and you know, the muscle you're gonna build is phenomenal. You're gonna feel like a boss. You have a strong ass. You have a strong ass ass.
Strong ass.
Strong ass ass. Why is things strong ass? Like, why is shit ass? You know what I'm saying? Or weak ass, fuck. Like, who come up with this shit? That's weird. All right. Anyway, we're gonna do 7 reps of pause reps. So this is how you do it. You go down. You can do it yourself. Take a 2 or 3 beat or count. Or it's better when you have somebody else do it, because you don't know when they're gonna say up. So your job is to go down, sit in the pocket, sit in that hole, and do not come up until I say up. And listen, when you come up, listen, y'all, when y'all come up, explode. Fire up, like, fast, rapid, hard. Explode, all right? Let's get it. Nice and deep. Good. Up. Good. Up. Nice. Up. 2 more. Doing good. Up. Last one. Up. Excellent. Good job. Noise, how'd I feel?
Good. I was waiting on that up.
All right, so we're gonna do a variation to the pause reps on this one. This could be used at the end of a workout, or you could do this in sets. So we're gonna do pause reps, but we're gonna shorten the amount of pause reps we're gonna do. Depending on how I'm feeling, 3 to 5, okay? And after that, she's gonna go right into squats, all right? So you're gonna bang out 10 right after that, like aggressive, boom. Like, so don't like rest at the top, come right back down. So she asked a very important question. She said, how do I breathe when doing a pause rep? With any squat, especially this, you take a deep breath, it's called big chest. It helps, it even helps with your posture on the squat. You take a deep breath before you go down. You hold it as you go down. As you explode up, you blow it out, okay? So you're gonna do the same thing. So now, what we're doing, what she's gonna be doing is the pause reps and then going into the squats. She's not gonna lock out at the top, okay? Let's do a demonstration so they can see. So, yeah, without the bar. So what she's gonna do is go down. I'll cue her where to go back down at. Go, bow, bow. Okay, save yourself. So the reason you're doing that is because we want to keep the legs under tension, under pressure the entire time. This is to get a pump, okay? When you come all the way up and take a beat, you know, you're getting a break. And this is not heavy weight. We're not going for power on this right here, but building muscle is going to make you more powerful. But we're going for straight pump, all right? So that's how we do it. Are you ready? Let's do it. So give me 5 pause reps. Come up strong. Up. Good. Up. Good. One more. Up. All right, bang out 10. Let's go. 1, 2. Come on. 3. Come on. 4. Come on. 5. Good. Come on. 6. You doing good. 7, good. Come on. 8, you good? Last two? No? You good? You got this. Come on. Drive. 1. Come on. Drive. Strong. Excellent. Beautiful. Nice work. Savage. That's savage mode right there. Good shit. Okay, so next you're gonna do narrow stance squats. Y'all see me do this a few times. What she's gonna do, we're keeping her weight pretty light. Feet are gonna be super close together. The closer the better, you know. So you're gonna try to maintain perfect form. Even though your legs are together, you're gonna try to push your knees out as you go down. Take that deep breath, just like any other squat, all the way in the pocket, explode up. Easy as that. You got this, champ? You got this? Let's do it. 15 reps, let's crank it out. Nice, bang them out. 2, 3, feet a little closer. 4, readjust, there you go. 5, 6, 7, this really brings out the quads right here. Come on, 10, come on, 11, good, excellent. 12, come on, 13, 2 more. 14. Easy fucking money. We like to call it like
easy fucking money.
Easy money, baby. Yeah. Okay, so next, we are gonna do jump squats. Jump squats are pretty dope. You can do them with or without weight. She's gonna do them with weight. I highly recommend these for explosiveness. Get some cardio in there. And you know, it kind of wears you out. And you don't have to do a heavy, whole lot of weight to get right to the money. So, we're gonna do 15 reps right here. The thing with jump squats, you wanna do a lot of reps, but don't like try to always maintain proper form, but keep moving, keep a good tempo. Cause if you don't, your mind's gonna catch up to what your body's doing. It's gonna be like, yo, calm the fuck down. Calm down. So we don't want that. We wanna get it in. Do all of the craziest shit that we could think of before our brain could catch up with our body, and then we're done, all right? So let's get it, 15 reps. And this is no different than any other squat. Maintain good form. She's got perfect form. 4, good. 5, 6, I'm sorry. 7, 8, 9, come on. 10, 11, keep going. 12, excellent. 13, 14. Boom. Easy fucking money. What, you say you want to do more? You want to do more?
Oh, please.
Good shit. Okay, so last but not least, number 5. You guys see it? Goblet squats. You could do this with a dumbbell or a kettlebell or anything heavy. You could do it with a baby. Hold a baby's head like this. A heavy, fat baby. Anything with that's weighted, you hold in front of you. You putting the weight in a different place, you'll feel it in your core, just like with the safety squat bar, but it's not as heavy, of course. So what she's gonna do, she's gonna hold it here. This also puts you in perfect squat position. It's an excellent exercise to implement in your leg days. And 15 reps, let's go, sit all the way deep into it. 3, 15, 4, 5, 6, 7. 5 more. 7, 12. But if you're feeling like a beast, you can get 20 without me asking for it. Come on. What's your count? Okay. Come on, get it. Excellent. Boom. And what is that called?
Easy fucking money.
Easy fucking money. All right, so there you have it. There's 5 different squat variations that you can implement into your programming. You can put it together like a workout, just like what she just did. The beautiful thing about that is you don't have to do 4 sets of each one when you're including all of them. How you feel? You feel like you got a legit leg workout?
Oh, for sure.
And all we was doing is demonstrating the movements. So you see how good it is. You can mix and match, put it all together as one, or add different things, take out different things, however. But these are different tactics that you can employ. We're bringing up your legs. Legs is important. That's the most important. If I couldn't train anything but legs, like if I had to choose between upper or lower body, I would train lower body. You know what I'm saying? Straight up. So that's why I do it so often. The legs are the foundation. You want to have a solid foundation. It burns the most amount of fat, the most amount of calories, because it's the biggest muscle group. So that's why we focus on legs so much. And fellas, Some of y'all don't be training y'all legs. Some of y'all be in a pool with baggy ass shorts on. You know what I'm saying? Come on.
All right.
Ladies like guys with legs, so let's get it. All right. Like, subscribe, comment, all of that good stuff. And we'll keep hitting y'all with fire content. Yeah, peace.